It's day four of the competition in Preston, where the week got off to a flyer with flamboyant ex-nightclub owner Nigel Evans providing a feast of Hollywood bling. It might have been a flop with Bernard.
We might as well not be here.
Why?
There's no one else in this room.
But it was a box office smash for the others, as Nigel notched a highly competitive 32 out of 40. Tuesday saw catering manager Valerie Holliday cook up a storm to try to better Nigel's evening.
This is just superb.
But her night of throwing up...
I'm going to throw up. Let me out.
And tantrums...
Not centre of attention.
It's Nigel. I've had enough.
Fell just short as she scored 29 points. Today, it's the turn of pumped-up beautician Dawn Barry to try and overtake Nigel at the top of the leaderboard.
Squeeze.
Come on. That's heavy.
It's not.
It is.
Right, come on.
Tonight, I thought I'd be nervous, and I'm really not at all. Looking forward to cooking, but I hope everybody likes my food. And if they don't, I'll just say, well, sod it. Here's a glass of wine. Get yourself in hot tub. Let's get wet.
And the week is brought to an end by the youngster of the group, Paul Morris, who's happy to be going last.
It's been good to see how other people have done their dinner parties, and I've just changed mine slightly to suit everyone.
Well, hopefully he hasn't taken any tips from last night's dinner party. Colourful carpet store owner Bernard Dorset hosted an evening from the Caribbean, but saw his hopes of winning disappear, along with one of his guests.
There's a fifth person, guys, missing for dessert. She's going to get to try this tomorrow, or at some other point.
Dawn finished her dessert this morning, and Bernard's nightmare evening was compounded by him scoring just 17 points. Not that he's noticed how badly it all went.
I was ecstatic about last night. Absolutely ecstatic. I had a fantastic night. That's what it should have been all the week.
Dawn leaving early last night is just completely nutty Dawn, isn't it? I mean, she's just in her own little world, just she does what she wants when she wants to do it. So.
I wouldn't have liked it if she'd walked out of my dinner party. I'd have been quite concerned.
So what's the dinner party escapee's excuse for her abrupt departure?
I went home early last night because I was absolutely shattered, so I rang my husband Chris and he come round the back in the Lotus and I opened the back gate and bombed it off down the back alley. I said, I didn't want to tell everybody we were going. I said, and I felt a bit rude, but I didn't want to spell the party before and asleep and putting it down on it. So I went out for camp, home, sleep, snoring.
Well, let's just hope you manage to stay awake to serve your food this evening. So what are the group expecting from the elusive Dawn tonight?
I think she'll start off like Nigel did. She'll be very attentive, but then as soon as a few glass of wine are inside her, anything can happen.
Dawn does not need any entertainment. She's her own party machine. That's enough. Nobody else needs more entertainment when you've got Dawn around.
She'll probably have no clothes on tonight. Or if she has, it'll probably be a bikini.
Val, you should be very careful what you wish for, as Dawn is indeed hoping to see some flesh tonight.
Dawn's pool party, obviously, fantastic. Can't wait to go there.
I don't know what's going to happen at the pool party tonight, but I just think it'll be ruddy outrageous, to be honest with you.
I think everyone will enjoy being in the hot tub. It'll just chill everyone out, won't it? When everyone's been stressed all week. Chill.
And having hopefully now caught up on her sleep, Dawn's feeling positive about her menu.
When I spoke to people about the kind of food I like cooking and things like this, they all said, oh, that sounds yummy, so I hope they like it.
Well, let's see what they make of your main course. Chicken fajitas with tangy tomato salsa, guacamole and refried beans.
Oh, nice. It's going to be a messy, stodgy kind of meal, isn't it?
Gosh, that's the main course. It's just like dips you would have round, isn't it, on a Saturday night? Wow.
It's homemade. I can't pronounce that word. Gommum. How do you pronounce that, please?
While Val tries to work out how to say guacamole, Dawn burns down to the shops to get her ingredients for her fajitas.
I've gone for fajitas because I've made it, like, week in, week out. I love making it. It's my favourite meal. Right, I'm buying jalapenos because, I mean, I'm going to put them on the table. They're not for everyone if you don't want them, but I like hot, spicy stuff. You can put it in, it gives it a right good bing. You'll have everybody on the toilet all night as well. That should be funny.
Hilarious.
Back home, Dawn sets to work in the kitchen. First up, she starts to separate 6 eggs.
That's cocked up to start off with, down the hatch.
All for her dessert, summer fruit pavlova.
We'll have to bit of skill to make it, so it'll be interesting to see what it turns out like.
I'll try to catch her out if she has been buying it in a supermarket, but, you know, maybe Dawn has some hidden quality.
There's not a cat in hell's chance she's done a pavlova. No way. I'll be very surprised.
Prepare to be surprised. Having finally managed to separate the eggs, she starts whisking.
Now, I'm going to beat my egg whites up. This takes absolutely ages. You've got to do it until... Oh, God, please, this is new. I haven't got this. You've got to do it. I'm going to end up using the handheld one. You've got to do it until it's stiff, so you can turn the jug upside down and it moves off out. And my arms are flaming, killing me the other day. Do you want to do it?
No, thanks.
It's rubbish, this. Mother, I'm going to kill you. It's kind of stuck. Has it had its day, do you think?
Yeah, it's not looking healthy.
It's broke, hasn't it?
Time for plan B.
No, do you not want to have a go at you? I'll do something else.
No!
I'm not joking, my arms are killing me. Can you just do it for me for a minute?
No!
No, really not.
It's definitely a no. Next, the torture for Dawn continues as she adds 6 ounces of icing sugar, a spoonful at a time.
Everybody in the world, I don't make puddings. I said, what's easy? Just give me an easy pudding. Somebody said, oh, Pavlova's easy. Just stick it over and stick some fruit on it. Yeah, all right then. This is time I'm sweating.
Finally, the agony is over.
Right, cool, I'm happy with that. That's ready. It's coming to a peach, so it's peeking up.
Next, she mixes in half a teaspoon of both white wine vinegar and corn flour before spooning onto a baking tray.
And if it all goes botched up, what I'll do, I'll just cover it all with the berries. See, that's all gone runny at the bottom, I don't know why. Can you see how it's all gone runny? It's all running away with me. Right, well, tough luck, that's the same as it is. It's going in the oven, I'll just have to try and cut it right after. That's my second bit.
And while the pavlova is hopefully rising, Dawn takes us for a tour of her house.
And this is a collection of some of my shoes. The rest are in the loft because I can't fit them all in. And I'll probably say that my most favourite pair, but I can't wear them because they're too high, are these. And I got these from America, and these are 8 inches high, which makes me about 6'3".
I think Dawn's house will be very dynasty.
I think it's going to be wild like Dawn, really. That's all I can imagine it's going to be like. Just wild.
Well, it certainly is wild to a degree, as it's also home to 2 parrots.
This is Ernie. He likes to spread his wings. He's cheeky. He's very naughty. And this one's Obo. This is a beauty. He's beautiful, isn't he? But they are the kids. They are our kids. We're not having kids. These are the kids. And they're harder work than kids. I'm quite sure, believe me. You can't shut them up. 4 o'clock in the morning, they're screaming, whistling, how much is that doggy in the window? And you're like, God's sake, I'm trying to go to sleep.
Sounds like bliss.
Yeah.
Back in the kitchen, Dawn turns her attention to her starter, prawn and avocado surprise.
Prawn cocktail, yeah. You know, I kind of, you know, dig it. It'll be okay.
I'm sure she's more than capable of doing that. More than capable.
You don't sound too convinced, Val. Meanwhile, Dawn begins by peeling 5 avocados.
Right, no, basically, because I went on a carbohydrate-free diet about 12 months ago, and this is carbohydrate-free, and it's still got all your fats in it and stuff, and it's healthy and it's good for you, and I enjoy it, basically, and I like making it, and it's easy. Everyone laughs at me at work. They all think I don't cook. They said, it's all you are is car, hair and makeup. Ha! I said, thanks very much, hang on.
Dawn then blends the avocados.
I'm going to add now mayonnaise, full-fat mayonnaise. Light mayonnaise makes it taste rubbish. Probably a good 2 good big dessert spoonsful. Then, great big good dollop of tomato ketchup. You can actually buy pre-made, but I like to do my own. Right. You don't want it to turn red either, by the way. If it's red, there's too much tomato sauce in it.
Was that almost a tip?
Oh, that's gorgeous. That's really nice.
Finally, she adds some prawns before putting the cocktail back into the avocado shells for presentation. And with her starter now ready, she checks on her mini pavlovas in the oven.
Oh, they're rising quite well. Touch them on. Nice and soft. They don't look like the ones in the flaming book, but, I mean, how many people are going to look like the ones in the book unless you're a professional chef? But, yeah, I'm happy. If anybody's... Oh, right.
They'll look even less like the ones in the book now.
That's mine knackered. Right, there we go.
If you want to cook non-knackered pa-